Hello everyone, in this video we have one square, two circle, one side of square is given 8, ratio of the radius of the circles is given as 2, and these red points are given as tangent points. The question is, what is the radius of the yellow circle? Okay. First step, if we connect these two points, and here, these are must be equal 90 degrees, right? Because of tangent. So notice that we get a small square. So these are must be equal r unit. Okay. One side of square is given 8, so 8 minus r left here. After that, if we connect these two points, here is 90 degrees, and this length 2r, right? Likewise, if we connect these two points, here is 90 degrees, here is 2r, and here is also 2r. So 8 minus 2r left here, right? If you focus on this quadrilateral is a kite, right? If we connect these two points, if here is theta, here must be equal theta. Likewise, this quadrilateral is a kite. So if we connect these two points, if here is alpha, here must be equal alpha. Okay. Notice that 2 alpha plus 2 theta equal 90 degrees. That means alpha plus theta equal 45 degrees. So theta must be equal 45 minus alpha. That's right here. Theta equal 45 minus alpha. Then, for this triangle, if we calculate tangent alpha equal r over 8 minus r. After that, for this triangle, let's apply tangent 45 minus alpha. Tangent 45 minus alpha equal 2r over 8 minus 2r, right? Let's remind you, tangent a minus b must be equal tangent a minus tangent b over 1 plus tangent a times tangent b. Therefore, if we apply this property for the question, the expansion of tangent 45 minus alpha equal tangent 45 minus tangent alpha over 1 plus tangent 45 times tangent alpha equal 2r over 8 minus 2r. You know that tangent 45 degrees equals 1, right? So let's write here 1 and tangent alpha equal r over 8 minus r. So tangent alpha equal r over 8 minus r. Therefore, if we equalize numerator and denominator, 8 minus r over 8 minus r times 8 minus r over 8 minus r plus r equal 2r over 8 minus 2r. Okay. Let's clear here. Therefore, these are again, and these are also again. If we simplify, here is r, and here is 4 minus r. So 8 minus 2r over 8 equal r over 4 minus r. Let's simplify again. Therefore, 4 minus r whole squared equal 4r, right? So 14 minus 8r plus r squared equal 4r. Therefore, if you organize the equation, we get r squared minus 12r plus 16 equals 0. So we get a quadratic equation. To find the roots, you can use delta, but I want to convert this expression to a perfect square. It doesn't matter. Therefore, r minus 6 whole squared minus 36 plus 16 equals 0. So r minus 6 whole squared equals 20. Right? Let's clear here. Therefore, we get two scenarios, right? Okay. Let's square root both sides of the equation. First scenario, these are again r minus 6 equal root 20. And second scenario, r minus 6 equal minus root 20. In first scenario, r equal 6 plus root 20. But notice that one side of the square is given 8. That means radius must be less than 8. So we cancel out. In second scenario, r equal 6 minus root 20. So 6 minus 2 root 5. Thanks for watching. If you want more videos like this, please don't forget to like and subscribe my channel. Take care and